हेलो चिल्ड्रन, माई सेल्फ ईश्वर चंद बलिचवाल वेलकम्स ऑल ऑफ यू। टुडे वी आर लर्निंग आवर थर्ड चैप्टर अंडरस्टैंडिंग क्वाड्रिलेटरल्स। ओके, बिफोर वी अंडरस्टैंड क्वाड्रिलेटरल्स फर्स्ट वी लर्न पॉलीगन्स। एज अ नेम सजेस्ट, पॉली मीन्स मैनी, गन्स मीन्स साइड, हैविंग मैनी साइड्स or having many vertex. A simple closed curve made up of only line segment is called polygon. Okay, here we have some figures. Here there are 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 sides, and they are closed. Again here they are 4 sides and closed, 4 sides and closed. All are closed curve, hence polygon. So first condition, they must be closed, okay, and having many sides. Now we take some figures which are not polygon. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this figure having 5 sides, but here this is not closed, that's why this is not a polygon. Here having many sides, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, but some sides intersecting each other. Okay, so this figure is not a perfect closed curve, that's why this is not a polygon. Okay, classification of polygons. How can we classify polygons? This is based on number of sides or vertices. Vertices means corners made by two sides. When two sides meeting at a point, they may have vertices. They have number of sides. Our classification points are number of sides or vertices. And how we classify? Simple figure. Okay, so take a look. Here there is a 3 sides or 3 vertices. 1, 2, 3, there is 3 sides, and by meeting 2 sides here, 1 vertex A, here by meeting these 2 sides, this is vertex B, and by meeting these 2 sides, this is vertex C. Here there are 3 vertex and 3 sides, that's why this is triangle. Okay, next polygon is quadrilateral, having 4 number of sides or having 4 vertex. Now here 1, 2, 3, and 4, it having 4 sides, and now we check the vertex 1, 2, 3, and 4, having 4 vertex. So either having 4 sides or having 4 vertex, and the closed figure is known as quadrilateral. Okay, next polygon, pentagon, having 5 number of sides or 5 vertices. Count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It has 5 vertices and having 5 sides, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and close also. Okay, now this way we can classify polygons. Now the next one is hexagon, means having 6 sides. Hexa means 6, so having 6 sides and closed figure. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is a closed figure having 6 sides, and we check number of vertex 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, all polygon having same number of sides and vertex. So we may take anything, either sides or vertices. Okay, Now this is heptagon. Seven sides or vertices. This is heptagon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. This way we can classify quadrilaterals. Now we take some more quadrilaterals. Here, number of sides or vertices 8. So the name is octagon. Octa means 8. Having 8 sides or vertices. Count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's why this is a octagon. Clear? Next. 9. 9 sides or vertices. Nonagon. Okay? So having 9 sides. Decagon. 10 sides or vertices. This is having 10 sides or vertices. Now this way, if any polygon having n sides called n-gon, okay, and the figure is according to n sides, okay. Diagonals. Now we learn diagonals. What is diagonals? A diagonal is a line segment connecting two non-consecutive vertices of a polygon. Now first we learn what is the vertices. Again, here this is our figure of different polygons. This is vertices because here two sides are meeting here. That's why this is vertices. Okay, here two sides are meeting, here two sides are meeting. And what is the meaning of consecutive? Consecutive means two. Consecutive means two continuous. Here one and this is two. So they are consecutive. This is one and this is two. They are consecutive. Okay, so here all the vertices are consecutive because after this there is C. If we meeting this, then this is after this A. So here no diagonal, because when we meeting two consecutive vertices, they are only sides. Okay, now here this is our first vertices, this is our second, so these are continuous, so these are not, these are consecutive, but this and this are not consecutive because in between these two there is a one vertices also. That's why these are not consecutive. These two are consecutive and these two are not consecutive. Okay, so this way we understand connecting two non-consecutive vertices of a polygon. Okay. Here we have some figures in which we join some diagonals. Here A and B are consecutive. So by meeting this, there is only a side. But after A, when we leave one and we take the other, then these are non-consecutive. So by meeting non-consecutive corners, here is a diagonal. After B, we leave one. Then we take other, then it is also non-consecutive. So when we connect by two line segment to two non-consecutive vertices, or we say corner, then we get diagonals. Here we start from A. After A, the next one is B. So we leave this and the other is C. So A and C are non-consecutive vertices. That's why we meeting them. This way, B and D, A and D, E and B, E and C, A and C. In each case, check if we take EC, then we left D and we connect E and C. So E and C are not a consecutive vertices. That's why when we connecting by line segment any two non-conjugative vertices, we get a diagonal. Okay, so this is our diagonals. Any polygon having many diagonals. Why? Because there is a many non-conjugative vertices. That's why that have many diagonals. Here, in this, PQ is conjugative vertices. So, this, by joining this, we get side. And PS is also conjugative vertices. So, by joining this, we get side. But here, when we meeting Q and S, this is not conjugative, because P, Q, R and S, in between Q and S there is a R. So we leave the one vertices, that's why Q and S not a conjugative vertices, and we are meeting this, and this is also our diagonal. Here after P there is Q, or after S there is a P. So in between these there is R. Although R looking nearer to P, but when we check the order P, Q, R, S, then PR is not a conjugative, that's why PR is a diagonal. Okay, this way we check what is the diagonal and how we found interior and exterior. Interior and exterior is what? Of a closed curve. If we draw any closed curve, then what is interior and what is exterior? Here, this is interior. Any closed curve having a boundary, outside boundary. So, the inner part of this outside boundary is known as interior. This is our interior. Okay. This is our interior. Here, this is also a closed curve. Okay. And this is the boundary, outside boundary. But here, this is inside. So, interior means portion of inside of outside. This is the outside boundary and this portion is inside. Here this is the outside boundary and we left the inside. We take outside portion and this is exterior. Inside portion is interior and outside portion is exterior. This way we understand these interior and exterior. This is interior, this is exterior. Okay, now we learn other things. Convex and concave polygon. Convex and concave polygons. Here, they all are polygon. But how we found who is convex and who is concave? So in convex, when we check the interior angle, this is interior angle. This is interior angle, this is interior angle, this is interior angle, this is interior angle. So inside of any polygon, if we measure or check the interior angles, they are always less than 180. All interior angles are less than 180. That's why this is a convex polygon. Check here. All are less than 180. Here, less than 180. We may take any angle. Here, this is the largest one, but still less than 180. So when we check their interior angle, they are less than 180. So we say that they are convex. Okay. Here, these are the concave polygon. Here, we check the interior angle. Here, this is less than 180, here the less than 180. But here, by meeting these two sides, the interior angle is greater than 180. That's why this is a concave polygon. The one more measure is, if when we make two non-consecutive vertex and they are outside of the polygon, then we also say that these are concave polygon. Here, the diagonal non-consecutive. After this, there is this. So this is non-consecutive vertices and we meeting them. And our diagonal is outside of this polygon. That's why this is concave polygon. So there have two measures. One measure is we make diagonals. If at least one diagonal is outside of the polygon, then this is concave polygon. And the other measure is, if the interior angle, at least one interior angle is greater than 180, then it is also concave polygon. Here, this interior angle is greater than 180 and this diagonal is outside of the polygon. That's why these are concave polygons. Okay, so we take definition of this. Convex polygon. Every diagonal of figure passes only through interior points of the polygon. Okay, every interior angle less than 180. This is the essential condition. So both these conditions here, the convex polygon follows. That's why they are convex. And here, the interior angle, at least one interior angle is greater than 180. And here the diagonal is outside of the polygon. That's why these are concave polygons. The concave polygon, at least one diagonal of the figure contain points that are exterior to the polygon. Exterior. This inside is the interior and this is the exterior, and that's why this diagonal is on the exterior part. So this is concave. Okay. At least one interior angle greater than 180. This is a very good characteristic we can check very easily. That interior angle greater than 180. Here, this interior angle is greater than 180. That's why this is a concave polygon. Okay? Like this, here is the interior angle is greater than. So by this way, we can found concave polygons. Okay. Complex polygon. Here we considered complex polygon, also called self-intersecting polygon. Any polygon have sides that cross over each other. Any polygon have sides that cross over each other are known as complex polygon. They are self-intersecting polygons. Okay, here we take this. In this, they are self-intersecting. They are self-intersecting. Okay, which are cross each other. These sides are cross each other. Here we take again another example. Here this side crosses to this side. So self-intersecting polygons are complex polygon. Okay. Now we take other things. Regular polygon. What are regular polygons? Regular polygon is a polygon that is equiangular. Equiangular means all angles are equal in measure. Always keeping this point in mind, that all angles are equal in measure are called equiangular. So in a polygon that is equiangular, and equilateral, lateral means side, equilateral means all sides have the same length, means all the sides are equal, then we call regular polygon. Okay. A regular polygon has three parts. Here we check different characteristic of regular polygon. Regular polygon has three parts. First, sides. All the sides are equal. So we can write all are equal. All sides are equal. Vertices. Having vertices and vertices make some angle. So all angles are equal. All angles are equal. Then they are regular polygon. Angles, interior and exterior. So all interior angles are equal and all exterior angles are equal. Then they are regular polygon. Now we look at figure. Here, this is a regular polygon. Why? And this is the symbol. We make a mark. Same mark on all sides means all sides are equal. If we make same mark on all angles, then all angles are equal. So take a look. Here, all angles are equal. That's why our both the conditions are satisfied. All angles are equal and all the sides are equal. Here, take this is vertex. This is the vertex. These are the vertex and these are the sides. All sides are equal and all angles are equal. That's why we can say this is a regular polygon. Now this is interior angle. Inside of a polygon and by meeting two sides, an interior angle is formed inside the polygon. And the exterior angle, when we extend one of the side in the same order, if we extend this, then we extend this, then we extend this, then we extend this. So we extend the sides in order, then we get exterior angle. Here we extend this side and this side, making an angle outside this polygon is known as exterior angle. Okay, so this way we can found that a polygon having these properties, then we call that regular polygon. I again repeat, first thing, all the sides are equal and all the angles are equal, whether they are interior or exterior, but all the angles are equal. Then we say these are regular polygon. This is a regular pentagon because having five sides and all five angles are equal. That's why we call it regular pentagon. Okay, this pentagon comes from this five vertices or these five sides, and regular comes from all the sides are equal and all the angles are equal. That's why the name is regular pentagon. Irregular polygon. What are the irregular polygon? Here we check what are irregular polygon. Irregular polygon is any polygon that is not a regular polygon, are considered as irregular polygon. It can have sides of any length, one side having different length, other side having different length, and each interior angle can be any measure. Each interior angle can be any measure. Then we say they are irregular polygon. Then they can be convex or concave. Both type, they can be convex or concave. Okay. So by this way we can check irregular polygon. All concave polygons are considered as irregular polygon. Okay. So always remember, first we check the polygon is regular. If that is regular, then okay. If not regular, then automatically they become irregular polygon. That is, does not have all sides equal. What? Does not have all sides equal and all angles are equal. If all sides are equal and all angles are equal, they become regular polygon. But if they are not having same, here we check a look. Here we check this side is longer, this side is smaller and this angle is greater and this is smaller. This is 90 degree, this is also 90 degree and this is more than 90 degree. So the angles are different. Here the angle is acute angle, here obtuse angle. So all the angles are not equal. That's why this is irregular polygon. Okay, if we make a triangle, let's we make triangle. Okay, and this is acute angle, this is also acute angle, but this is obtuse angle. So all the angles are different. So this is a irregular polygon. And the sides, this sides is greater than these other sides. That's why this is irregular polygon. So this way we can check. Here, if we consider a rectangle, here all the angles are equal. They are all 90, but this is not a regular polygon because the sides are, all sides are not equal. So always remember, both the conditions must be satisfied by a polygon, then we say that is regular polygon. What are the conditions? First condition, all the sides are equal. Here only the two sides are equal. Okay, the opposite sides are equal. And the other condition is all the angles are equal. Here the second condition is satisfied, but the first condition is not satisfied. This side equal to this, but this side not equal to this side. These two sides are equal, but this side is not equal to this side. So all four sides are not equal. That's why this is not a regular polygon. Okay, so always remember, both the condition must be satisfied. All the interior angles are equal and all the sides are equal. Then we say that is regular polygon. Otherwise, we consider them as irregular. So this is irregular polygon. Clear? And always remember, if you understand anything, then please watch the videos up to the end. Then we understand everything clear. And if you all people subscribe the videos, then you get the videos timely to you. So always remember, if you like, then subscribe it. Okay? And have a nice day.